Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today the liturgy invites all of us to reflect about our spiritual diet and our spiritual calories. With this spiritual diet and the calories, we need to grow in the love of the Holy Eucharist. We need to have love for the Holy Eucharist. And we need to deepen our faith and conviction for Jesus. I have a beautiful story that I read last night. In the early 1970s, during Vietnam War, there was an archbishop, his name was Ban Thuan. And this communist saw him as the biggest threat. Thus they arrested him and imprisoned him. And he was in his, you know, solitary confinement for 13 years. He was not allowed to celebrate Mass and he was not allowed to receive Holy Eucharist. But he was given one luxury, to write letters to his friends. When he did, he asked them to send him his medicine, his personal medicine. So his friends understood what was his medicine. Thus they sent him this cough syrup or cough medicine bottles. And in the bottles, they filled wine and little pieces of bread for him. And this little, you know, bottle of wine and pieces of bread made him, you know, celebrate heaven on earth. This archbishop made small wooden cross with a piece of wood, and he hid that cross in his pocket. And every day at 3 p.m., at the time when our Master Jesus died, he celebrated Mass personally on his palm. He just had little drops of wine and water in his palm and a piece of bread in his hand, and he celebrated Mass personally. The crumpled cell, the crumpled prison where lots of lives were persecuted and exploited became, in the history, place of miracles. Through the history, we saw lots of miracles taking place in that particular prison at the place called Saigon, because of the celebration of the Holy Eucharist and the presence of the Lord through the Holy Eucharist. And today, that crumpled prison is a beautiful, glorious cathedral where daily the masses are celebrated. This archbishop's thirst for Holy Eucharist brought God in the history, brought Holy Eucharistic Lord's presence in the history, and brought miracles for hundreds and hundreds of people in Vietnam at Saigon. Today, in the Gospel, we hear the beautiful teachings of Jesus Christ about Himself, the Holy Eucharist, that He is the bread of life and He is the spiritual diet for our holiness. For the past five days, we have been reflecting about this Holy Eucharist, Jesus telling about Himself that He is the bread of life, He is the bread of eternal life, and He is the source of heavenly abode for all of us. We need to reflect about our diet. At times we worry too much about our physical diet. We want to be healthy, we want to be fit, and we want to be attractive, beautiful, and handsome, so on and so forth. But at times we least bother about a spiritual diet, the spiritual calories that we need to have. From the beginning of the week, Jesus was, you know, preaching about multiplication of the bread and the bread of eternal life. He provided people the physical food through His multiplication of the bread. And afterwards, He was preaching the proclamation of the kingdom of God, where He provided food for their mind. And these days, He is proclaiming, He is preaching about the true bread for the soul. In Greek, the word for bread is arthos. That means the general food. Jesus mentions that particular word when He preaches arthos. He is the arthos. That means He is food for everything. He is our physical food, and He is our mental food, and He is our spiritual food. When I truly desire for Him, when I truly long for Him, sure, I make my life sustained in holiness. have in the East these lots of saints who just lived on Holy Eucharist. Saint Catherine of Siena lived 7 years just with the Holy Eucharist. That satisfied her holistically. And we have Saint Nicholas of Cluny, who lived for 19 years just with Holy Eucharist. And we have Blessed Alexandria, who lived for 13 years just with Holy Eucharist. We have lots of saints who got satisfied of the presence of the Lord in their life and sustained their holiness and remained wonderful witness of the providence in the world. What is my personal experience with the Holy Eucharistic Lord? What is my thirst for Him? And we are all here in greater thirst for Him. Sure, He quenches our thirst and He satisfies our hunger and He is everything for all of us. So every time I come to receive Him in my heart, in my soul, in my body, let me be worthy vessel of Jesus Christ's presence in my life. Let's pray for His grace. And let us bring more souls to Christ. Especially pray for those souls who are away from God. Let them get converted, come back to God. Praying for this grace, let us continue in this holy mass. May the name of God be glorified. Amen.